to the Red Lion Inn, which was built in 1704. When I bought the place, the owner approached me and says, "You want to buy this place?" And I said, "What am I going to do with this dump?" It was raining through. The kitchen hadn't been cleaned for 10 years. The only thing you could eat was Campbell chicken soup and hot dog. And people were living upstairs for 30 years for 40 bucks a week. So I made him a ridiculous offer. He told me to get out of here, which I did. And he called me up and he said, "I accept your offer." I said, "I never made an offer. I had one drink too many. Are you out of your mind?" And then I was dumb like a box of rocks, because what happened is I had to put sprinklers in and I had to put an elevator in. I was $2 million down. And I remembered when I bought this, now I'm $2 million down. How are you going to get your money back? And then I said to myself, functions. Gotta have the functions. So I started, I blew the whole place into pieces. The only thing left was the fireplace. If you look at the ceiling is since 1704. I stored it outside, I brought it back. If you look at the fireplace in the back, 1704. Everything you see, which you're going to see, I constructed, I designed, I built myself. I wanted something unique. I kept the wood outside, I brought the old parts back, I kept the old fireplace. Now, when I came to America, I was in the computer business. And I was president of some large companies, big Cohasset, because I could live on the water. All the famous people who are coming to the social music circus have stayed here. I spent $10 million of my money here, the bank wouldn't have given me a dime. And what you got is a nightclub. You have an unbelievable function hall. In Europe, weddings are different. There are 100 people max, and it goes for 24 hours. I built the Salon du Soleil. It holds 100. I found very fast out that that isn't enough for America. And that's when I built a beautiful hall, and I didn't want the blue carpet and the white walls. I wanted it perfect. And that's when I built the Lion's Hall. And this barn now, we did over thousands and thousands of weddings here. I wanted something totally out of this world. I had my vision. Rustic, rustic, rustic. But then I said, now you got to put some elegance into it. That's when I bought the chandeliers and all the little lights you see with the red light. I found them in a magazine when I was traveling around the world. The food, they say, is unbelievable. It's not function food. If you want to have your wedding here, I love to have your wedding here. I love to host it here. You can call me personally. 12 years here, we did over thousands of functions. When I built the place, I said, I want to have breakfast. Then I want to go to the pool, then I want to have lunch, then I go to the pool, then I have dinner. But I said, what am I going to do at night? So I said, I need a nightclub. You can book for private parties, a lot of birthday parties, a lot of anniversary parties. You can have food, you can have anything you want. You're going to have a blast. All the rooms have fireplaces. The rooms are all different. It's complimentary for the brides. I call this Brasserie Sap. The food is out of this world, and that is our chef, Rashid Kurda, and he worked for Wolfgang Papp.
All right, so tonight we're going to have the special. We have the chicken egg rolls. Unbelievable.
Chicken egg rolls?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
So you got the whole beautiful plate right here.
Now what you see, it's the most beautiful stove in all of America. It's called the Bonnet. And it cost me $135,000. And we had to tear the wall down to bring it in. I wanted character. And that's what this place is all about. It's about character. We got it all.